In this video, we are going to create an expert advisor that is able to identify trends on different charts. So let's find out how that can be done for MQL5. To get started, please click on a little icon here or press F4 on your keyboard. Now you should see the Metaeditor window, and here you want to click on File, New File, Expert Advisor from Template, Continue. I will call this file Simple Multi-Chart Trend, click on Continue, Continue and Finish. Now you can delete everything above the Ontick function. And let's also remove the two comment lines here. We want to start by creating an array for the price information. That can be done by using MQArrays. The name of the array will be priceinfo. Afterwards, we use ArraySetAsSeries to sort our price information array from the current candle downwards. And now we use copyrates to fill it for the current symbol on the chart and the currently selected period on that chart, starting with the current candle 0. And we will store the values for 3 candles in our priceinfo array. Now we want to create 2 variables. One is called chart signal and the other one is called EURUSD signal. We don't assign any values here. Let's continue and create 2 arrays. One is called EMA20 array. The other one is EMA EURUSD20 array. And now we can use the integrated IMA function that comes with MQL5 for the current symbol on the chart and the currently selected period on that chart to calculate the exponential moving average for 20 candles. We don't use a shift value here. This parameter is called mode EMA, that stands for exponential moving average, and the result should be calculated based on the close price. Let's continue, and this time we are doing it in a similar way, but the first parameter is hard-coded for the EURUSD. If you click on the symbol in the market watch, you will see a name that might be a different name depending on your broker and your account type, so please make sure that you pick the right one. Everything else is similar. So now we can use ArraySetAsSeries for both arrays to sort them from the current candle downwards. And now we use CopyBuffer for both arrays, the one for the current symbol on the chart and the other one for the EURUSD, to fill them for buffer 0, starting from the current candle 0 for 3 candles. And now we can check the trend. We want to check if the current candle 0 is bigger than candle 2 for the EMA20 array. If that is the case, the signal for the current chart is buy. Otherwise, if the value for candle 0 is below the one for candle 2, that would be a sell signal for the current chart. And this part is basically the same, but for the hard-coded EURUSD. Finally, we add a comment statement to output the values for the EMA20 for the current symbol, the EMA20 for the EURUSD, the trend for the current symbol and the trend for the EURUSD. And that's about it. Well, if this was too fast for you, or if you have no idea what all the code here does, you maybe want to watch one of the other videos, or maybe even the premium course on our website might be interesting for you. There you can also find some links for source code downloads like this one and a shop link. For now we are done. Please click on compile or press F7 on your keyboard. You shouldn't get any errors, and if that is the case, you can click on a little button here or press F4 to go back to MetaTrader. And in MetaTrader, please pick an empty chart. Go to the navigator and pick the simple multi-chart trend expert advisor and drag it onto the chart. I will allow the modification of signal settings, but it will not actually trade, it will just show us trends. And when the next tick comes in, you should see that the current trend for the Canadian dollar against the Swiss franc is a buy trend. Now please click on Insert, Indicators, Trend, select Moving Average, pick a period of 20 candles. For the exponential moving average, we don't have a shift value, and the EMA should be drawn for the close price. Now please click on OK. Here we are, and we can see we have an uptrend. That is correct. Now you can right-click onto the chart, select Templates, and save the template. I will save it as default.tpl in this case, and override the current one, because default.tpl is what you see when you open the next chart. Now let's do this and open another one for EURUSD. And now you should see the exact same values for both calculations. And that is the way to check out if it really works. And in this little video you have learned how to create a simple expert advisor that is able to calculate trends for different charts and show them on the chart that you have picked. And you have coded it yourself with a few lines of MQL5 code.